into the grove. It's a very important holiday in Scandinavia, to Nordic cultures, especially the Vikings. Did you know that many of our modern Christmas traditions actually come from those cultures? The Christian church absorbed a lot of them. Help us emulate those populations. Like what? Oh gosh, a lot of things. Here, take off your coat. Have a seat. I'll get us some hot drinks. We can share some stories. Here you go. I know. The days are finally going to start getting a little bit longer. We're through midwinter. Spring will be on its way soon. But first we have to get through this night. It is the time of year when the veil between worlds is much thinner. There are many things out in the forest, on the roads, especially at night. Listen to the wind. Although some say not all of it's the wind. You're lucky you found this place when you did. How long have you been traveling? Ah, dangerous. Very lucky. You're safe now. Here, enjoy your drink. Warm yourself by the fire. Those traditions. Yeah. Well, one of them is the ham. Traditionally, there were rituals and feasting at midwinter. It lasted for the 12 days of Yule. That's a little different than the 12 days of Christmas. It actually began yesterday, on Mother Night. It's the night before the shortest day and the longest night. And it goes all the way through the beginning of January. And during that time, it was common to sacrifice a boar to Frey, the god of fertility and farming. It's where our ritual of ham at Christmas comes from. Yeah. And I don't partake myself, but I know a lot of people enjoy it. We have some here tonight. Mm-hmm. I'll have the cook make you a plate. You can enjoy some food while we talk. There you go. Oh, yes. Our cook is quite a wonder. Please. You're our guest. Another tradition. You noticed our wreath on the door when you came in. Yeah. It was common to build circles of evergreen bough and holly and other various objects and then set them on fire and roll them down the hill. No. And that was supposed to symbolize the coming of the sun. Because once the solstice is over, the days start getting longer, the sun comes back. And even though we can't see it yet, can't quite tell yet, spring is there, waiting, under the ground, under the surface. Life is coming back to the world. Mm-hmm. And some people think that's where our Christmas wreaths came from. It's quite interesting, huh? Oh, the log in the fireplace? That's our Yule log. It was common to take a very large oak log and carve runes in it to ask for protection. And it was decorated with holly and fir and then put in the fireplace on solstice and to keep the fire going all night, although it is important to save a piece of it. And you keep it in your home as protection for the year. And the next year on solstice, we'll use it to light the fire. Yeah, it is beautiful, isn't it? A nice big roaring fire is protection against the elements. Yeah, there is mistletoe up there. Oh, even that has a story as well. And the Vikings believed that mistletoe could actually resurrect the dead. Well, there's a legend about Baldur, the god of light and goodness. He was killed by a mistletoe and resurrected by his mother. She turned the red mistletoe berries white with her tears and raised him from the dead. How's your food? Good? You're starting to feel a little better. Wonderful. Santa Claus. He's a big part of the myth. Even him. And that takes me back to the hunt. Are you sure you didn't see them out there? Galloping through the sky, everything in their path. Sounds like they're close. Odin would be leading them, riding his eight-legged steed, with his white beard flowing. The children have been told to leave hay in their boots, to set them outside for his steed. Hunting makes it hungry. And if they're good little boys and girls, and they've done that, then he just might reward them with sweets and presents. So that when they wake up in the morning, they don't find hay in their boots, but rather other things. Sound familiar? The Christmas tree. Most especially the Christmas tree. It's beautiful, isn't it? I helped cut it myself. No, we went out during the day. We wouldn't go out at night this time of year. The Christmas tree, the evergreen tree, forever green, forever full of life. They would decorate the trees with food and clothing, small statues of the gods. They would carve runes in the trunk and the branches. They believed the tree spirits would leave the tree in the winter. And they were trying to entice them back for spring. It wasn't until the old religions were outlawed that the trees were moved inside. It was a way to still continue practicing their religion without being persecuted. The tree symbolizes something else as well. It's a symbol of Yggdrasil, the world tree. It was the foundation of many of their beliefs. And the world tree holds all nine realms in its branches. It is what holds the universe together. And all the creatures, humans, giants, the dwarves, everyone. We're all in its branches. And when Ragnarok comes, the end, it's not really the end, it's just another beginning. Because everything will be reborn again from Yggdrasil. Only this time there'll be no evil. That's what the legends say, anyway. Have you ever heard of Arthur Lundqvist? No? He was one of Swedish literature's great tree worshippers. I think I have one of his books here. I do. Read you something that he wrote. It's quite beautiful. Here it is. In every human, there is a tree. And in every tree, there is a human. I feel this. The tree wonders inside a human being, and the human being is caught in the tree. I serenade the forests, The far sea is the second sea on earth, the sea in which man wanders. The forests work in silence, fulfilling nature's mighty work, working with the winds, cleaning the air, mitigating the climate, forming soil, preserving all our essentials without wearing them out. I know, I love that. The forest sea is the second sea on earth, the sea in which man wanders. By planting something called a care tree or a guardian tree. It was in the middle of the homestead. It was a miniature version of Yggdrasil, a stately landmark in the courtyard, a figurative expression of the interdependence of the world around them. It had a soul which followed the lives of those who grew up under its shadow and its boughs. If the care tree had witnessed many families growing up, the relationship between the tree and the family would have been strengthened. And this relationship was very private and very confidential within the family. Many of the care trees can still be seen in Scandinavia, if you know where to look. So the Christmas tree is really so much more. Yeah. Isn't it beautiful? I know. Oh, your cup is empty. Let me get you another drink. Of course. Yeah, move closer to the fire. I think we probably should. The night's getting late, but it's far from over. The wind, it's getting stronger. The hunters are out in full force now. Let me get that drink for you. Here we go. Not for the faint of heart, and that's for sure. How about if I tell you a story? It's very old. It happened quite a long time ago. You see, it's not just Odin and his Valkyries, dead warriors from Valhalla, and other creatures that participate in the hunt. No. There are some humans. People who practice magic. Who merge themselves with the hunt. Leave their bodies in their beds and let their souls run wild. And then there are those who are unwittingly taken. Those who had no intention of participating. They get swept up in the chaos and the madness. I do have a story. It's a cautionary tale for those travelers who stay out just a bit too late or decide to take the shortcut through the forest. I want to take their chances on a deserted country road. Come closer. For the night is dark and full of terror. There was a man, a farmer. He'd been in the city during the day and decided to try to take a chance to make it home by nightfall. But of course, you know how short the days are now. It would have been impossible. Halfway home, the last of the light left the landscape. He was enveloped in darkness and cold. And the wind began to howl, and the trees began to shake. The snow was falling. He was desperately cold, but knew there was no turning back and no stopping. He had to press forward. He walked as quickly as he possibly could, almost breaking into a run a couple of times before he caught himself and slowed down. The landscape itself was straight from hell. You see, because hell's not a place of fire and brimstone, hell is a place of ice and snow, darkness, and bone-chilling cold. It's the frozen north. As the man continued down the road, inching ever closer to home, he began to understand what the afterlife would be like. That's when he heard it. He heard them coming. He heard the stomping of sleepers' hooves, all 8 of them, and the wild howls and roaring of warriors set free, of Valkyries collecting souls, of all the creatures of the 9 realms, screeching and howling together. Odin leading them as they froze the world, and they were coming straight for him. He ran as fast as he could run. It didn't matter. Next thing he knew, he felt strong arms snatch him from the road. He was thrown onto the back of a white-winged horse and gripped onto the waist of a Valkyrie for dear life. And the rest of the night is a blur, feasting and fucking and running and madness and joy and a wildness like he never thought possible. It consumed him. And when he awoke the next morning, laying in the threshold of his home, his children's boots beside him, filled with sweets and toys and presents from Odin, he shook, remembering his brush with the divine. He was very lucky. Not all travelers returned from the hunt. You were very lucky. Not everyone traveling in the dark actually makes it to the light. Those are the old stories, the myths, the legends. Oh, but the solstice is so much more than that. So much more than stories to scare children and wayward travelers. It's a time of rebirth, reflection, and time for us to take stock of what we have. Be grateful and decide how we're going to move forward for the coming year. Oh, I've already done my Yule cleaning. Yes. So what are you grateful for? It's wonderful. What are you looking forward to? That sounds very good. Well, I'm glad that you made it. And that you're able to warm yourself by the fire. And I had someone to tell my stories to. I do love to tell my stories. I'll let you sit here for a while. Continue warming up. Enjoy your drink. And just relax. Leave you here by the fire.